you haven't tasted rice until you taste Auntie Flo's Quilombero rice. It brings out the flavor and taste in every meal. It's priced right as well. $4 for 2 kgs, $10 for 5 kgs, and $100 for 50 kgs. Available at Eastgate Market Shopping Center in Harare and Fidelity Life Center in Bulawayo. Or simply WhatsApp us on the numbers on screen now. Auntie Flo's Quilombero rice. Delicious, tasty, mouth-watering. From as little as $20, your Christmas and New Year's could be filled with entertainment. We provide free-to-air decoders, smart TVs with built-in satellite receivers, tech support for all our products second to none. Find us in Harare, Mutare, and Mashingo. For more information, WhatsApp us on the numbers appearing on screen now. Kesson Electronics. Grab yours today.
Hello guys, my name is DJ Ollah 7 0, and we're coming out of the Chief M Marshall on your number one podcast show in the land, the Ollah 7 podcast show. And yay, happy 2024, happy new year. And we look forward to, you know, a fruitful year, 2024. I'm sure Messi Magadze Rose Nyuan Mugorenyuan really. I mean no matter matter tagari my resolutions Gorenyuan that's G as about 10 days chi Easter to Tanga Tamu ma 10 days Miami to Tomanya now. And tonight I'm hosting one of the very or most talkative, should I say, Michinde Arosaza, Arozi El Gringo. He is in Zimbabwe right now. Let me just say hi to El Gringo, my brother.
How's it doing?
No, I'm good. How are you?
Boena.
It's been like, I don't know, my guy at the bay in Dara Tongo when I meet social media, which is Pisa Muripo, Magarin Zimbabwe, Magarin Zimbabwe.
22 December.
December?
Yeah.
Oh, Samaratama Christmas, we don't know. New Year.
Christmas, New Year.
Jesse, how was it?
Very nice. Yeah, very nice. New Year to no people in the church, guys.
Oh.
New Year to be in the church.
When you go to church, man?
Because FIC.
So El Gringo, you're originally from Banget, am I right?
Yes, 100%.
Banget. So at what age then did you move to Harare?
I moved to Harare when I was supposed to be going into Form 2.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's when I moved to Harare.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if Chitungwiza is Harare, but I moved
Harare
to
province. Yeah, it's Harare province.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So from Banget, I went to Chitungwiza. Mm-hmm. And that was Form 2.
Mm. So was it for greener pastures or
Myers?
Chikoro.
Chikoro, but moms anga waenda ona. Moms anga waenda ku Botswana. Anga no shanda.
Right.
Kwazi zato ambo chaka chaka. Bosi chanchango vava 08 pampaka woma last.
So
moms
anga for 8 anga mawana.
Yeah, ando vatishi vakumbono chaka kuti zvinhu zvakamira sei. Ufuji zuzu mbange tumajuna ta itu chaka ufuti. Titu uleva fana wa digi digi. Chitika sa chibake, chichichichi, wheat, flour, chida idai. Wazia. Saka later then moms vata ininda kena chaka. Wazia. Wazia inini mtalongo kafa 2002.
Hey.
Exactly.
Kumbari ni makure mga nipo?
2002 wakufana kusubtract amaya. Shada
wakufana metima. Kumbari grade dan?
I'm fine. I think that is 7 years.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, so I know I'm fine. I'm good too. Oh, I'm fine. I'm going to show them dig dig. Yeah, I'm going to show 2002.
Oh,
exactly. So I took off the cooler and mom's shit. So I'm mom's if I chug. Last, I shut up a GMB banget.
Okay.
Exactly. So I graft and banget me last. So later on, things became very hard. GMB acho chibagejanze sauye varongonga sipo ona. Then at the end of the day, mom vodzo decided that man zanga mbono chagoshi pa Botswana man chagi graft.
Yeah.
Mom zvodi Botswana. So we ended up yet to go kunogara na mine nichi kuchitungwiza ona.
Okay. So wakazoendera rembiri nechikoro chako form 2 yako wakavhamirira ipapo.
Zvaitika patakasvika kuchitungwiza mari yambo pakangoitika kakunetsa kemari. Ndakawana mira chikoro. Ndakazo continue after a year. Mm-hmm. But that whole year, ndaka pay and sing in those school.
Yeah.
Eh. But ndakazo continue after a year, ndakazo no ndzapa seke two high
school. Seke two high, but yeah, eh. Yeah, I understand. Eh. And I mean, I want to know about your upbringing. To kanyato kudzwa say.
Oh, chaka kudzwa zvakanaka. Sisi chaka kudzwa zviri very strict. Although we grew up with a one parent,
mm-hmm.
But we grew up very, very strict. Mm-hmm. I was a prefect school.
Okay.
Yeah, I was a prefect school. School in the primary school, I was going to say, I don't know, I don't know, but a blast, a rough, smart, wiser, Saka takazongonza ayo, you know what, ever since wachichena, rimskanzo wa iripo, saka mwite imprefect pangwana kwa sayo utase, kuzonzora, uwa angwe bozi, izu takatanga ufamba ni makuru utaitero kwa primary school, kunzi uyu ndo mkuru wedu, kuprimary. Saka zikutero kwa zike, afina kutanga my.
Saka takina uyu kuprimary.
Kuprimary, that was my leader.
Se unta rongoto uwe.
Eh, ndo vandas obvious kwa futu prefect.
Wow, wow, primary school.
Ah, and chiri kwa I think that was a prefect for 2 years.
Kaza jai.
Oh, headmaster kata, ah, you are to run. Taka subatuwe chiba mangu. Wakata, no man. Munu ngaite se, ngati mom visa iti mboona. Mvada biswa. Mvada mom zimba ya tangwa, mvada nesko panika nga chikoro mbange ti mom.
Exactly.
Mvada shkai kuko mvada nzi prefect footi. Wasi nalika hipa.
Exactly.
Ah, wanandri top top. Top last.
Dopo waji manya footi.
Eh, no vanda ito prefect. Iba wanda zo biswa, biswa mayo prefect.
Awazo go
prefect. Pala mnada kuzapa chikoro chi Roma manji.
Okay.
Eh, but secret that. Mm-hmm. Eh, nakazapa St. George's Primary School, mm-hmm. Paris School.
Mm-hmm.
Vanda ya vapa Paris School from grade 7. Grade 7 nani 12 units.
Wow.
Yeah, vanda mm-hmm. vapa vanda enda pa pa Sacred Heart mm-hmm. High School. Ndo banande grova ipapa apo. Ndo vandazo reform 2 ndo patakazo.
Yaku. Olevo yakabuda se.
Olevo marisasa sandatora.
Yeah.
Mhm. Asati.
Koinda.
For me, I didn't see the reason yekunomatora because by the time that I was waiting for my Olevo results,
uh-huh.
I had already found what I wanted to do.
Okay.
And I was already investing into what I wanted to do.
Which is what?
Which is computer science.
Mm-hmm.
So right now I'm a data scientist.
Okay.
Yeah, software mm-hmm. engineering, data analytics, business kwa, intelligence.
Kwa hivyo ndo kuyuniversity. Hivyo ndo kuyuniversity. Manje kuyuniversity kwa hivyo ma results all level.
Exactly. I didn't go to any university.
Mm.
I taught myself everything. Everything that I know. Right now I work for Standard Bank, South Africa.
Wow.
Everything that I do there is, I did certifications later mm-hmm. on, but I was now doing these certifications with the money that I was making from my business.
You know, there's an interview you once did with Patsani.
Exactly.
You know, I was watching that interview and, you know, in that interview, you mentioned that wakakasika kukura and also kubajita mari, YP, wewewe, na mama wako bozo, waishandaji, it has a cross-border, nechi.
Exactly, yeah.
So are you the first born in your family?
Yeah, I'm not the first born.
Mm-hmm.
I had a sister.
Mm-hmm.
My sister, she was older than me, 4 years older than mm-hmm. me. She died.
Oh.
Exactly, sad. Yeah. Yeah, she died. Mm-hmm. So I became the firstborn.
Mm-hmm.
So at that time, I had to force myself to grow up.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You see, the difference between me and a lot of guys out there is that I did not get everything on a silver platter.
Yeah, yeah,
remember, I told you when we moved to Chitungweza, mm-hmm. then we ended up now staying alone.
Yeah,
and it's just between 1-2 years,
mm-hmm.
then we moved out to Denmark. Many technology opened, much to
yeah,
you need to see.
Mm-hmm.
Then now, Maria to me, one of moms, yes, to tell you in any personally, in good in digital anger, good in the man, a great lag to pay and a carapana. Gandhi shouldn't be in a choro. I registered myself for Beam Deck. They don't meet up a QA BIM. BIM is a BAM. Yes, your government.
Hey.
Yes, BIM paid my school fees.
Mm-hmm.
Form 2, Form 3. Pains one, what out Zingwa Isusu Moon, I should go up, Pachi Mila Tabuda, Tessanga Leper, Dota Sanity, Zera, Tabuza, school fees at Robada. Dova, I don't register stuck BIM. BIM paid my school fees.
Mm.
So all of these things that people see, they don't really know where we come from at all.
Yeah.
So after that, now I'm staying with my two little brothers. Mom's
mm-hmm.
Arapo.
Yeah.
So Maria to me zero. I had to budget, which okay, in no marriage calf, in no marriage rent, in no marriage mfura, no magets. So you see, ipapo.
Yes.
And mariri kuya iri maranzi, you know, change wa chi, mm-hmm. grocery mm-hmm. tumidziru, no budget kwa sii grocery, vana wa muka iri, vana kuchukuru, mwana zoka, everything.
Mm-hmm.
This, I'm doing this, and I'm 17 years.
Hey, that young age. And what lesson did you learn? You know, kukaska kuta mwana, kukura, I mean, kukaska kuta mwana mkuru, uchini mwana mdiki, you know?
It's now goes back to what I always tell people on mm-hmm. internet, that look, when somebody does not have a responsibility,
yeah.
they take time to grow up.
Mm.
Or if you turn every responsibility, you see it as an excuse,
mm-hmm.
you don't grow up.
Yeah.
One son is saying, hey, talk across number, baba. Wonder talk across number. Hey, you need that number zero or anything. Taste at number zero or anything.
Very true.
Why bother? So it made me grow up very fast. And I had to make that responsibility my way up ladder, because I knew that no one was coming to save me. It's me and my little brothers, and I have to make these guys go to school. Maxine, you know, to guesses. Domana, considering I threw a pass. It's a no. What about?
Yeah. Life here, Kura, Gringo, I'm sure a lot will relate. It was Wajinja and Akura Zuri, all roses out there.
Exactly.
My one, my challenge is a lot of body. Kunano gona nas, Kunano gona, El Gringo, Animari, El Gringo, you know, who's out there, Asta Vera, Asanganima struggles, Akafana, and Augustanangura. So, I know Tuagazo moved to South Africa. When did you then move to South Africa and for what reasons?
So, when I, after O level, I started working for a company called Supreme Panel Beaters, right by myself.
Yes.
I think I was the youngest IT guy there. Yes. I started doing writing my invoices with the computer, the software, writing my invoices.
Yes.
But then later in the time, then I was
there.
Not really. Not now. You know, paramura. So I'm going to
paramure.
Paramure, but I don't boba. And I don't boba.
Exactly.
You go in here, go to.
How do you go? Boba. As long as you go, you go.
That's not boba. I want to go in here, go. Zanzi turu ni aya. Ma pindira na kaita bas.
Yeah.
And it.
Right.
Oh, na ma pindira na kaita bas. Agazu turu tindi so vovot.
Let's talk about that. We're going to go pinda si.
Ayo, ugona, I had a friend of which ngari mwana umrizo kamba.
Right.
That's as much as I can go.
Ngari mwana umrizo kamba. Ndiyaka kupinza bagraft.
Ndiyaka kupinza bagraft.
Vakazo badwa.
Later on, pamba tungu ni chuma fracas, tuandwa ngwiti. Plus, at that time manje, I was young. And pfungwa za singa na tushande, zaka naga saka. Uri mwana mpiki, mareka vatanga kuya. I think I was earning $35 a week.
Wow.
Yeah, I started earning $35 a week.
That's huge.
Back in the day. Back in the day. This is 2014 that I was earning $35 a week.
A week.
For 5 days. Every Friday.
$35.
So I got a pizza. Last. Easily. I got my first car, which was an X-Trail. Munagawa pa graft. Achidawi God series. Nobody that deal in a person and as a tenga motae, but he is ye.
Exactly.
Oh, and when I told our common paper grafty, a common paper graft, and another to ye mutango gazira, mota pa den pang, emotkari, chichi, mota client, gazira pa den pang, water. So soon would sing sabasses.
All right.
Yes, soon would sing sabasses. So I started driving extra in any. 2014. Yeah, it was my car.
So, Pogas in South Africa, that was which year?
Vanilla South Africa 2015. And Yakunupera, Vanilla South Africa. Moms have an idea. I get a one actually a paragraph, Pando graft, and in a Murunguacho Nachi is a CEO IT company.
Okay,
Saturn Consul Kupaji an internship since Yoshi, which is just my computer, so my website, you got my website.
Yeah,
I started making my first website in 2015.
Wow.
When people didn't even know how to operate Google. I had already, I was writing HTML, CSS.
Wow,
I was writing that, that code,
yeah,
back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's when I moved to South Africa in 2015.
Then, when one of them was born in South Africa, I got to teach a
My, I was not owing anybody here in Zimbabwe. I did not do any fraud. I did not do anything. I left nicely. Nakakwira igulide na rangu pa ningirikina apa ni passport yangu.
Wakaenda nekudzoka.
Ndakatokwira bazi rangu igulaina ndavanda tonanga paJoburg.
Undo kwakuna momzi yako kudara.
Ndo kwakuna momzi yangu kudara.
So azvina kukunyanya kukurwadzira pa kwaSouth Africa since wanga ari foreigner kuti udzunyaso kutaka kushanda graft chari.
Myers, I got there and I had an overwhelming welcome from my uncle, my mother's brother.
Yes.
Then I was staying there in Kempton Park. And ndaikwira train ye yellow. Neza train ye yellow ine ngitaro monitor kana kumusika nadzo iziya. Yellow kuti vanhu vanobatira chinobiwa singaite. Yes, I was boarding that train every day at 5 a.m.
Uchienda
ndichienda ku graft. Ndaishanda kunonzi ku Centurion. So,
Century, yeah.
So I would board that train around 5 a.m. Basa richitangana 9.
Yeah.
Ndo shika pa nonzi ba Irene station. Ndo shika ipapo around 6 a.m. Andid. Ndo famba netsoka about 2.5 kilometers kunoshika pa South Downs Office Park. Kubva pa Irene station kunoshika pa South Downs Office Park, I think it's about 2.5 to 3 kilometers. Ndo famba netsoka ndakatakura laptop yango graft. Unzo.
Yeah.
Ndo kundinochika ndinoita internship yangu ni.
Yeah.
This happened for over 2-3 years. No, actually. Because I was cut 2016.
Yeah. But then get your internship in 2016.
Nigeria, I was an intern, I was earning 2,500 rands.
Rands.
Yes. Oh. And imagine 2,500 rands in Muna go Zimbabwe and NGP 35 US pay 5 days.
Yeah.
Now I'm getting 2.5.
I understand, you know, what are you, I mean, self-taught software engineer. How did that come by? Is what I was saying.
Dairova, kunema websites are one in the internet. I don't know now. Nini kutintango zidzira for website creation, nakaita panonzi pa w3schools.com and YouTube. That's where I taught myself most of the things that I did.
Ibab.
Although later on, but ndakazoita SAP certification, kaita Oracle certification, all of these certifications. Right now I'm busy doing my degree now. Ndakutozotanga kuda kuzviita nechi. But right kuto register chego chego degree roro kuti ndange uriita. Ndipana pandakamboti ndakuda O level. this is my work experience. Company ninyorero recommendation. Company ninyorero recommendation.
So our chances are like the maturity entry.
Exactly. Company ninyorero recommendation. My papers, my certifications. I'm going to do it. Kato mama ndo chinjando da kuita ichi. Vatambi ra katai omona. Kwaso nyora shima matigiri anungo to online.
What would you mind?
Doctor chango tunyoro.
And even though you're known as the youth leader, youth president, you know, we see you live on Instagram. Which popo who gave you that title?
I gave myself that one. It was not occupied. It was very.
It wasn't free. Occupied.
It was not occupied. It was not occupied. Everybody else started coming in. This is a youth leader, youth president. Inin couldn't also recognize wa. That position was not occupied. No one was there.
So. Chichinoya, what comes with that title, you know, as the youth president?
It's not kuti takagona upenyu. And it,
yeah.
Tenge chitodzidza ndichitotaura ne vanhu chitodzota iwa usaite so ndikutodzidza wandiri ipapa. Kwabata.
And in, but I want to know El Gringo, you know, as a youth president or youth leader, as you call yourself, you know, what good have you done for the youth as a leader?
I have done quite a lot, eh? I've done quite a lot. Actually, if you are to find out, my benefit from, I've given them everything that I've done. The studies, I've managed to be able to provide my tutorials, my lessons, everything that I used to be where I am. Wangwafana wakatondi uzo, I'm Dara, mdinema testimonies aka wanda wakapunda mu Instagram. Dara, thank you, my tutorials, ndakawana graft. Ndakudaiso, Dara, ndakazodaiso.
Yeah.
Tukwetu wangu, tunotumbata, sompo, tumari, yote, amfana wangu, imbo, endo, neka, koto tindigandina.
Yeah.
Kujerere mwa 2000 ndakatoburitsa $120 ndine 150 ndakatoburitsa $120 ndikasara ne 30
then
ndakatani akawanda.
Yeah, Holy 10 also calls himself youth leader.
I know, leader of the youth.
Yori youth leader.
President of the youth.
Okay. Saka makasiyana.
Takato siyana. Urgona iye anditi. Ano leader my youth through his art of music.
Yeah.
Anditi. But not so much that we are learning from him.
Yeah.
He has made a lot of mistakes within a very short period of time.
What mistakes are you talking about?
We are talking about a lot of mistakes of going on a song, she took her, your baby mama, all that. That's nonsense that you're just not supposed to be
doing.
Is
it direct though? Is it direct? Or is it maybe it's just a song?
We don't, we
maybe see, then people are assumed.
Because Zimbabwe had daro manje babongo. Mugabulita song yenyu banapa. Mona zadnet ndoza ndakasiyana nevazhinji. Vazhinji vanotsika kuzotaura mazita. Inini kana tisina kuhira ndakutotsemura ipapo ipapo. Mfano wangu kwewe. Tutomfarira last. Music yake kwafunza madhamu yangu ndozoti most played music iyo kudeni kwedu iDelila. Tinchinzwa holiday. Tinagirwa nai. Ndotaka ndomtara nai pa WhatsApp. Akanyorera tamba kudaiso. Kati mudara. Ndozvakaitika izvi pakadai. Mwana wangu ndotochengeta mudara.
Exactly.
Andi ndikati saka keep your head high. Usaite se saterere vana. Chita yauri kuita. Iri mo message chacho ndokuratidza. Andi yakareba rese holiday njiniwe rot onai ndakadai ndakaita kuchitunzana ndakadai chiusungaita same.
Andi
but inya dzevanhu.
Yeah.
I don't really invest so much into that.
Yeah.
But the moment now you want to lead the young people, you now have a following of a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Your voice now represents something. There is an influence that comes with your name.
So when you release that song, did you
when you're now releasing a song now that is about fighting and what took a winky d what die what die. You see, when it's you, if you don't respect the name Ola Seven, you become useless.
Yeah.
Because the influence. That's why I texted you a message when people saying, "Hey, hola, hey, unoita basa kudedza vanhu chivasina basa kuno kuti usatere zvipenga." The name Ola comes with the influence that people follow.
Exactly.
Zvangu fana neni. There are a lot of people that follow me. Apana kwandu yena kwasinga mhores, Gringo, Gringo, yeah, Gringo. Ah, solutano tuzvarira. Ah, Gringo ntara zvipenga. Yeah, Gringo ntuka vanhu handiti. But there is that influence.
Yes.
That comes with your name.
Mm-hmm.
The respect that you hold when people are talking about
yeah.
you. There is a power in people knowing you.
Mm.
You grew up in a family singa shige 500.
Yeah.
You
know? Yeah.
But now there are thousands of people that all of this.
Exactly.
If you find yourself not respecting that name and not respecting that influence
yeah.
and seeing it and taking it for granted, that right now, do you know that right now, me, if I start saying to, I go on internet and start telling people that, Olawewe aswe aite taka satanist ndakazoenda ku podcast kwake ndakona zvihari chichi. Do you know that there are thousands and thousands of people that will believe me
they
will move away from your YouTube?
Exactly.
Atidiona zvinezvi Gringo akati
ehe
wasi
very true.
Do you know the reason why I did not go publicly and say pamberine Zambia? Do you know that?
No, we don't know why.
The reason that I can support ZANPF personally for my own personal reason.
Yeah.
On this. I know in I drive my single road, yakanaka ndikapfuura pa bed bridge ngatitwa zvakanaka. I have a nice car. My GP number plate car. And ndakauya nayo for the first time kuno kai nauta si. I know gwechenuka zvandakamboita nayo pandakabhuya nayo.
Exactly.
These are my reasons to vote for ZANPF. The reason why I did not go in front of people and now say now everyone votes ZANPF is because my reasons for saying I like ZANPF are not somebody's in Kambozuma there who's struggling, who does not have 120 ektora passport. And the kwanise kutora mashoko angu inini. Ndo mashandisa kuti ayi wachivotera bato rangu inini randati ndirikuda. Ndisina kunzwisisa upenyu wemunhu ari uko kuti acha benefita usei. Hanzisi ndosiko chindiona ndichizovhunduka ndichijamukira ma minister kuti iwe unopenga herewe zvauri kuita hazvisiri izvo izvi uri kusvibisa strategy yemusangano wacho wauri kuti ndiwo wauri kusafamba nawo handiti inyaya kuti ndine influence but I don't want my influence now to mislead the young people. I care a lot about them.
Okay.
Hanzisi
so now on a scale of 10 how is the youth, you know, in our country behaving?
You see, it's a sad generation globally. Our generation is very, very sad.
Mm.
Because there's a lot of things that are transitioning into reality, mm-hmm, that we did not think they would transition so quick and so fast.
Mm.
We did not have podcasts. We did not have internet.
Exactly.
We did not have Instagram.
Isn't
it only OnlyFans, Baba?
Yeah.
You would chakwe kungo visa yembe, pambere pe camera, maria kutupinda.
Yes.
I know somebody we have seen. I like I told you, I'm a data scientist.
Mm-hmm.
So I download a lot of data from the data governance, mm-hmm, body.
Mm-hmm.
Data. So you download a lot of reports, my economic, mm-hmm, reports. I downloaded the OnlyFans one. Trying to see how long this company, how much did they make? Exactly. I'm talking about billions of dollars that they made. And I'm talking billions of dollars is to the company.
Yeah.
But I'm talking now, we talk about millions and millions, over 500 million, yeah, that one individual made from one website, from just switching on camera iPhone or Visa MB. That's it.
Maria Pinda.
And this stuff is happening into this generation that people don't understand. And people in Zimbabwe, they are cultural. They take time to grow out of a lot of things.
Yeah.
That's why there is a conversation that nobody wants to talk about. The whole LGBTQ, about gay people and
exactly,
what. Nobody wants to even to get into that conversation.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Because we are cultural.
Yeah.
It's something that you need high IQ, very, very, very intelligent,
mm-hmm,
to even go and get into that conversation.
Yeah.
Because it's a conversation that is determining the future of Zimbabwe.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that?
Yeah.
People are sitting in Europe there, in a parliament,
mm-hmm,
deciding, talking about the future of Zimbabweans,
mm-hmm,
but using LGBTQ people. Somebody, a child is being born there in Kambazuma, not knowing that kuti achi chingwa muna 2027,
mm-hmm,
there is some people sitting there deciding kuti mwana acha gay, but they are using gay people.
So what's your take on the LGBTQ subject?
I personally don't have any problem with those people.
Mm-hmm.
They don't affect anything.
Mm-hmm.
They don't do anything. I can get into a train with them. I don't get any problem.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have any problem. I'm a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
My beliefs are not supposed to be imposed on people.
Yeah.
I'm not religious.
Would you date a gay guy?
No, I can't, because I'm straight.
Okay.
I'm 100% straight.
Mm.
I have the most beautiful woman on earth, my wife, that I married and paid a lot of money for.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So that, I'm straight, is that.
Mm-hmm.
But me being straight, I don't impose my straightness on somebody that I don't understand.
Should I say, maybe, would you support maybe LGBTQ in Zimbabwe, not as an individual, in Zimbabwe, to say, okay, would you advocate for that?
You see, like I said, it's a subject that requires high IQ. You need to be very, very intelligent.
Mm-hmm.
It's not something that I would answer that I would support.
Are you saying you're not that intelligent?
Yes.
Answer that one?
No.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not highly equipped
to
be able to get into that.
Into that one, yeah.
Deeply.
So, you know, talking of Nyadze behavior, this youth, you know, few months ago, a video of a certain guy, you know, surfaced on the internet. Achiputa shisha, you know, it was, you know, achira shisha. Then he would see smoke yache ye shisha. Achi furi drama private parts emwana scan. So what's your take on that?
Okay, you are talking about the kanonzi Isaac. Like I told you, what you made a mistake when you called me. Me, I talk about the names.
Yeah.
I had people have to know.
Mm-hmm.
One is a
secondary
president.
Okay.
Okay. My leader. They are running with Chichka. That is nonsensical behavior.
Mm.
I did a live and I explained that this, we do not tolerate this. But now it comes now to the respect that you need to put in women.
Mm-hmm.
And this respect has been taken away already.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have the likes of Shadaya, who are very popular,
yes,
that have no respect for women.
Mm. Oh, you think Shadaya has no respect for women?
I don't think, I know.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he doesn't respect women. No, he doesn't.
But I interviewed him a few weeks ago. He said, I do respect women. No. I just state facts.
Ola, ugadi jina driver kwenye, then to sanga na ni uchi driver kwenye. But what out driver kwenye? Do you know that there are people who are driving kwenye tiva in a class 4?
Yeah.
But kuma paper kwa nyo nwanzi ti. I had driver kwenye.
Mm-hmm.
And it.
Yeah.
Inini, I think, I like his message sometimes. Sometimes we take up his message. But there's that bitterness on women. Women make mistakes, but men makes more mistakes than women.
Why do you say so?
If a woman sleeps with one man and then breaks up with that man, then goes and sleeps with another man, you're calling a prostitute, right? She's sleeping with a lot of men. What about a man sleeping with a lot of women? You're calling a prostitute maker.
Prostitute maker.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a man sleeping with a lot of women. So, are you telling me that men will make these mistakes and it's fine?
It's not fine. It's never fine. Either way.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So, when young people approach certain topics, you need to make sure that there is so much power that has been put into a woman.
Yeah.
So much power that has been put into a woman by God himself. You understand?
Yeah.
The power to bring life to on this earth, it's something that no matter who you are, you have to acknowledge that. You have to acknowledge that. You have to know that, okay, no matter how many mistakes these people will make. They want to bring out this whole Andrew Tate thing. This whole, what do they call it? Alpha. These people are not alphas. They are weak, these guys. These are weak guys.
Hey.
If you spend so much time talking about women, so much time being rattled by a woman, something that was created out of you. You believe that she was created out of you, and yet she's rattling you like a... and you call yourself an alpha.
Are you opposing his facts? Like most of his, you know, my statements, I got no, my opinions, Agisha, are you opposing them? Most of them, or do you have maybe some?
I have some say, that I even agree.
Yeah.
Say, okay, mukuratana chokwada. Mukuratana chokwada.
Yeah.
And but it's not everything that is always right. You understand?
Yeah.
It's not everything that is always right. You see, effect is made effect through the scenarios of its future relevance and past relevance. That's how effect is made. It becomes effect because you think that, okay, maybe this part that he said is holding so much power on certain things.
Yeah.
That's how you make effect.
Mm.
But you cannot tell me that all women did it. Yeah, single women did this. Single women did this. I'm more of an alpha than all of these guys.
Why?
And I was raised by a single woman. I've made so much difference in this life.
Yeah.
Physically and spiritually, I'm even bigger than most of these guys. And they call themselves alphas.
is this like a direct attack to Shadaya?
It's not a direct attack to Shadaya. Shadaya has a lot of followers. I'm not attacking Shadaya. Why would I attack the guy?
Yeah.
The guy is trying to, he also, you know, the fight, he's fighting poverty. But he also want to come out. We're all fighting poverty. He also want to come out through his teachings.
Okay.
Let me tell you something. Do you know that I've gotten businesses from women That if Shaddai would get a chance to sit with those women, mm-hmm. because he said something that was very, very stupid, mm-hmm. like the stupidest statement that a man would ever say. He's a drunk man, what, because four women, what, kunzoko. To my minions, do you my comment section? Oh, yo, Alpha, Alpha, or Gucci, you go Jamuru, Alpha, my pen, Zimi. See, you go Jamuru, Alpha, Papa. I've gotten businesses. Do you know that right now in Zimbabwe,
mm-hmm.
if you want to talk about the biggest industry,
mm-hmm.
actually in the whole world, one of the biggest industry is mining. Do you know that?
Yeah, very
it's mining. Mm-hmm. In Zimbabwe, who has more money here in Zimbabwe? A miner or some social media chalachan out there? A miner.
Miner.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Who leads the small scale miners in Zimbabwe? Do you know who that?
Hmm.
Henrietta Chua. Yeah. Is that a man?
No.
Is that a man? Do you know that Henrietta led Zifa? Do you know that?
Yeah, I know.
She led Zifa.
Mm-hmm.
When she led Zifa, Van Olta, he was a crook in DED, what.
Yeah.
He was not even a president back then.
Mm-hmm.
There was no influence there. Hey, on the IPIs come, you know. Kanaka icha kune vanhu vangani ko vane senemi yo yekuti munangagwa. Vanhu vangani vangani senemi yekuti mugabe. She fought Muzifa memi.
Zvekutodaro.
Muzifa memi. Chichigichiri chiganda goria chiri imomo. Mukadzi watikutaura.
Yeah.
Mukadzi watikutaura. Izo zvitori kutotsa tuda kugadzira system yakati yakati ya small scale miners. Gringo, picha company yako tinzwe. Right now I'm there sitting, talking to these people, sitting in him. I'm listening to them. I'm trying to understand. I've sat in board meetings where I'm sitting there as the technology guy, as the data scientist, trying to put in business intelligence report, presenting it to them. Mm-hmm. You understand?
Yeah.
Big corporates.
Yeah.
I've worked for Liberty Life. Liberty Life is one of the biggest corporates in Africa.
Yeah.
I've worked for Standard Bank. You understand?
Yeah.
I've worked for Absa Bank, which was Barclays. I've worked for Oracle. You understand?
Yeah.
I've worked for Telecel. Not Telecel, I mean Cell C
in South Africa.
In South Africa. Through Ignition Group. I know about mobile virtual network operators that people don't even know what it is, Jens.
Yeah.
You understand?
I'm
that intelligent when it comes to my field. I know.
Yeah.
But then I'm sitting in that meeting, listening to this woman talking to men in there. We do this. They're explaining.
Yeah.
I feel weak in there.
Yeah.
I can tell that my brain right now has been exhausted by the ideas that these people are coming through.
Yeah.
Then there's a guy out there sleeping in some spare bedroom there, coming to us now telling us what women for what men it puts like a man. Viapa. Nonsense, guys.
Ah, that's Shaddai for you guys, and I'm going to take you back a little bit. So, what kind of punishment, you know, do you think suits that man? Because I mean, if ever he deserves a punishment,
you see, the respect on women, the abuse on women, it's like oleo kanzo tanzadzia kuriku abuse kwaiwe. Motemo ngaunge uchiti. Nyango akati asikuda kulaya ma charges. Motemo ngaunge uchiti. Zvangu fana nemunhu ukatsika munhu usina license. Motemo unoti. Nyango munhu yeye akati aiwa mistake yanga iri yangu bo but unosungwa.
Yeah.
Kuti nda white driver iwe usina license.
Yeah.
Motemo ngauti kana pari pa abuse on women. Whether it's verbally, whether it's on internet, if you start abusing women, the moment you start abusing women, there is that thing. People need to start respecting women more, and people need to start pushing the agenda that men are also being abused. Know this, but it needs to be out there that any abuse,
yeah,
there has to be a punishment. Mm. Whether you report it or you don't, there has to be a punishment.
Yeah.
Let's put respect. The Bible says so.
Yeah.
Put respect.
So now, you know, there's a word that has been popularized in the streets of Harare. Yeah. You know, slay queens as well as slay kings. So what is the definition of those terms in your own thinking, your own opinion?
I don't really know, you know. I just think that people, when they see someone who bath, dresses well, smells nice, put on a wig, we have nice nails, a man who has nice clothes, is they calling slay. Yes. It's not a bad term. It's good. You're slaying. You're slaying. Being a slayer is not, it's not bad. It's good. Embrace it. If people call you a slay queen, embrace it, my sister. If you, if somebody call you a slay king, embrace it. Because wakachena vanhu vabvuma kuti uri pamusoro pedu nakirwa ne life hakuna munhu anomboya chikumakira kuti anzi hechi enjoy nakigwa isanzara dzako dzakareba kudai so as long as tuzonogona kusvika mablets kumba kwenyu kana kuti murume wekuden kwenyu achinakirwa neskiriro itaskiriro haikona kuswero chinonzi hey slay over what you tell feel a bit kuti aiwa kunzi you are a slay queen azvino kuti uri hure kana kunzi you are a slay king azvino kuti uri hure uri kungozviroira chismart chako nakirwa neupenyu hwako tango to roa kana ndo tswero cherera tapfana ndo to pfurira answer zvina tsakana cent
ndo pfurira answer
eh tsakana 1 rand
El Gringo, you know, there are some women and men, you know, I mean, who are going extremes just to display a certain lifestyle, you know, out there on social media. So some have joined cults, others, you know, are now fraudsters. Ninya idzodzo chichikudaro na El Gringo.
See, especially on that, that one is very important. You see, we can look at an angry scenario. Marie katanga ku mbiri katanga ku ya. Marie satia uya. Mbiri yoshika.
Right.
Yoti mapa nda uya gringo mbiri. Iyo Marisa tiauya. Zvino zvakatoitika kwandiri.
Right.
Pandaitaiwa apa ndazogona upenyu.
Right.
Ndanda zvitengera ka C class kangu ndakurera mupenyu wangu kana ka South Africa. Unzwisisa?
Yeah.
Ndisinei nayo internet. Instagram ndiye ma stories. That's why uchiona pa unoposta zvinonzi post a story.
A story, yeah.
Because you have a story to tell. Kana usina story urikuiteiko ipapo.
Ipapo.
Ipapo because you have no story. I was not on Instagram till 2017 maybe.
2017?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think so. I dated some girl that made me go on Instagram. I was not even there.
Wakazopindwa nechimoko.
Eh, kuzvinji itozvozvo zvimatsito midhi izvozvo. Asvinge zvona kudzizvo. Kuzvinji unetumari kauti unazvo kunini ne story ka. Ndikufamba ne Benz ya 2016 muna 2017.
Yeah.
Ndikupisa ka.
Exactly.
Ndakamboya nayo moto iyo ku Zimbabwe wana akaiunganira ku marokeshi.
Iwe una sengwe.
Oh, is moto kaipe.
Exactly.
Okay. Una undane story ka.
Yes.
Ndakuzvita ndichigandichizvita zvine. But that was a lie. Inda imbiri yakazotanga ukauya ndobvaya overtake basa rekuti ndichiita mari yakati o.
Okay.
Mbiri yazara pandiri izvo mari hapana.
Hapana. Okay.
I mistake iri kuti kana vapfana mudown ndoma vasikuziva kuti mbiri ikakurumidza kusvika. Iyo mari isati yasvika.
Yes.
It's a problem for you. Because anyone now who's supposed to be giving you money is expecting money from you.
My goodness, my goodness.
Certain people that are supposed to be giving you businesses, now they are scared to approach you.
Yeah.
There are people that are scared to approach me.
What of the lifestyle that you have portrayed?
Because I've put in this lifestyle that is not there.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand?
Yeah, I get it.
That's a very, 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 very big problem that we have right now.
And you know, it's quite sad because social media in real life. And people are struggling then to balance live social media near real life when we get to their places. Oh,
there are people that are even obsessed with this internet life. I've seen people with money that we say, hey, post me, because they want this relevance. He has already made a lot of money.
Yeah.
He's a millionaire. He's now telling a guy like me who does not even have a million in
to
his
say
account.
That's all.
Post me. Make me relevant. But now you are now attracting certain things that are coming with fame.
Yeah. Well, we are still there, Gringo. It was rumored that you portray a fake life, you know, on Instagram, but in real life, you've got nothing, you know, in your name. So what do you say about this?
See, It's people who get obsessed with the lifestyle that I live. You understand? A lot of people, even you heard, ah, no, Gringo is a fraudster. Yeah, no, it's a Yahoo. What? I know, beat our nation. I'm a straightforward data science guy. Go on LinkedIn. Search Alois Mzea. You see, everywhere I've worked is there. The history of me is there on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
Companies find me there, gives me jobs. The money that I earn is enough for me and my family. I'm able to build my mother's house.
Wow.
The person who brought me into South Africa, working as a maid, I'm building a house.
Well done.
You understand? Right now I'm working towards Rufi and Netsa, Rufi and Netsa, Rufi and Netsa, Rufi. It's me now. But you never see that. Let me tell you something, Ola.
Yeah.
There was a time somebody posted me driving an ML or so. So I can go drive a motor. Do you know that to me, that statement and people, listen to me. This one, this is the first, very, very most important thing that I'm about to tell you now. When people expect me to be driving a better car than I'm driving now, that's success to me. I was nothing. I grew up in Bangit, Neshama, and I think such a bag in Bangit location. I got 50 kg, Quenda Nego road, Kunzuka Govan, Kuno Mira Panopura, my motors go for Quenda Chino, Karipachi, no Mira Papa, you take such a bag. Inini. The former Bangit made me. Now we have to go Harare. They end up in Jambanja, who takes us my suits, which my biscuits, my chocolates, Quaseco in Jambanja. Inini. Now I will expect that in the family motor I can knock at the end. I'm successful.
Yeah.
I like it. You are not pulling me down. You're actually acknowledging that I'm not supposed to be where I am.
Yeah.
Which makes me more interested. It inspires me. When somebody says, ah, gringo, life is good. I see you. I know. First, you ask for no ngari up.
Abba,
of which I'm nothing. Ola, let me tell you something. We grew up with nothing.
Yeah.
For me to even see myself sitting here, to invite corner some.
Exactly.
Even mbiri, actually, everything. I monetize this face.
Yeah.
This El Gringo thing, I'm monetizing it. A lot of people, I was called into EEG I was called into EEG, given a position into EEG with just seeing that, okay, this is El Gringo, this is the face.
Yeah.
Come.
Let's do this.
I've met the president's sons there. I went there.
Yeah.
Met Collins Mnangagwa, presented my idea. Look, dude, this is my bara and daughter.
Exactly.
Collins had a nakiron idea.
Exactly.
Presented the idea to his mother, to his father.
Exactly.
Me.
Yeah.
Inini. Would you have thought of that? Mama ungu inini waibi kama samusa so mbanget. To uvopina na umtowns. Vachino matengi isa. I had a whole year of not going to be able to go to school.
Hey.
There was no money.
Yeah,
I stood in front in the camera pa line kurwane van pa line beam kuti beam in badari score.
In badari was school fees guys.
And then then somebody comes and says moti hard good driver. I see you. Jumbo driver.
This is quite an interesting story coming from El Gringo. And you know what? This is some of the things that we don't know about you. when we see you on social media, we get this, you know, side of the story. Oh, yeah, no chance is a side that we choose to use. Kuti uindie El Gringo. But there is the a real El Gringo. What is Kunzwa? But while we are still there, El Gringo, you claim to live in a 3 million rand house.
That is true. That's not a lie.
Is it really your property or your wife?
You know, the you know something called mortgage?
Yeah, yeah.
You understand that?
Mm-hmm.
You can borrow, right?
Mm-hmm.
A bank, you can borrow money from the bank, and the bank can buy it for you.
Yeah.
And then you're now earning your salary. Mariachi
yeah,
you then you pay a mortgage of 16,000 rands from your salary.
It's a ganishwa.
Is that hard to do? When you're a data scientist like me,
mm-hmm.
I earn about 800 rand an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Me.
An hour?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I work about 172 hours a week.
Mm-hmm.
If I do overtime, I'm going to get 200 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Those are all takes energy. Be like a fan by age. You can come to my house.
Yeah?
I can invite you in my house. That apartment, it's an apartment.
So you did not buy it, I mean, cash?
Mm-hmm. I'm an employee.
Yeah?
Although I have to my small companies, don't try to build that.
Yes.
To Sumuko and to my businesses.
Mm-hmm.
Those are ninja, man, some is in Zimbabwe.
Mm.
As you know, after we go now, pay new.
Yeah.
But to go Zama, go to go ne.
Hey.
To go Zama, go to go ne.
That's powerful, El Gringo. That's very powerful.
Anyway, I will tell you, Ola. Kuira hamba namo. Ne pesa pandi no go na kuira hamba kuta andidi.
Yeah.
The fact that I don't want anybody to see me. Is poor.
Mm.
Even this is not one rand
musiwoyo.
Life in the chiku inspire and I go and build this skill.
Mm-hmm.
I've said 100 times on my Instagram. The future of the youth, it's not something that you encounter there.
Mm-hmm.
You just miraculously find yourself there.
Okay.
No. The future is what you make of it today.
Mm.
It's something that you start building today.
You prepare for it.
Opportunity meets preparedness.
Mm.
Every day there's an opportunity, but if you're not prepared, you don't see it.
Yeah.
Powerful. You don't see it. Every day there's a guy in town there looking for something, looking for a solution.
Yeah.
Looking for a solution to a problem that he has.
Mm-hmm.
And you are the solution, but you are not prepared. Mm. Every day, unongozi go, aywa, pambe ni diligence sama numara. Me weva, nwaka fane mara, nwaka fane mara. General Gupi, you were not prepared. You did not know. It happened, and it went.
Very true.
But $100, shisha, ne NS, yega meister, success. Oto nongi, you are successful, steady.
Ogro na giriwa.
$100.
Cameras on.
Kutaza gazika na mwana wa munhu nekutaona mfeso wake akabata $100 place.
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah.
So that's why I'm telling you all of these things. It's not like kutaka gona upenyu, but my responsibilities akati chinja.
Yeah.
What is this?
Ndababata.
But time ekuti ninde kwanza uvunuka $100 ini. I could not nekwatakataza kuivunuka $100 because that's a responsibility of an uncle.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. People don't know about this. My little brother, the two of them, the other one is a senior developer, front-end developer and back-end developer. He writes Drupal.
Wow.
In France.
Serious?
Right now, he's about to work. He signed a contract. This boy is 22 years old. He's 8 years younger than me. Do you understand?
Yeah.
He's actually 20. He's born 1998. Nah, 2002.
Yeah.
2002 is how old? Is that 22?
Yeah, should be 22.
Yeah. He's about to work for the European Economic Organization. Go and Google that company.
Yeah.
It's a multi-billion dollar organization.
Yeah.
That this young man is a senior Drupal developer there. I paid school fees for that boy.
Wow.
From nothing. When my mother said, when I after form four, I said, Mama, so I have my boy.
Get the
gun. I paid school fees for him.
Mm-hmm.
Right now he's in France there For him to start kunakirwa necomputer, yeah. Aitora yangu so. Mm. Tanga kuona timda. Ku template ndita same data. Mm. Template iri Joomla. Ditsana kugadzira ma website.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You grew out of me and mm-hmm. started doing things that I could not
yeah,
do.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You see, right now, Gampins, the message, Babongo, he's on a Europe tour, he's enjoying life. I'm going to Spain as well.
Mm.
These are young people. If you are to look at, I'll give you a picture mm. of the people I'm talking about.
Mm.
I'll give you a picture. Check out Garaso, Namayvang, Mumbam Banget. This is not
going to be
Bakosiro is here, Babongo.
Yeah, he's here.
Ndakatsemu kachigunwe jiji. Ndakamira mkiuye bakosi. Inini mama wangu apfana wangu vese 34 takamira. Kutituwani munu wese ave papa akatakura something.
Samari.
Akabato aenda ni ilangi. Eno indo ni ilangi. Mm-hmm. Aenda ni chakati. Aenda ni chakati.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Mm,
yeah.
Nazo zunduna ndiri pandira apochora. Tazo na hauda. Hayo wargu nyebe utanemari.
Hmm. Mawan.
I'm okay.
El Gringo, you know, how far true is that what you say about passion Java, you know, also applies to you. Paguti unoti ano chengetwa nemo kadzi. Duma shoka drones waya. Ana chake yet in actual fact anzi you futuru kuchengetwa oneji.
Oh yeah, yeah. How can that be possible?
Mm.
How can that be possible? My wife doesn't work. My wife she was born in 2000, my wife.
Mm-hmm.
She does not work. Hmm. She did some degree I ended up with a hostess. After that, I married her and I told her, sit down. Don't do those things.
Yeah. Sit down.
You don't do those things. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
My wife, what she does, she buys a lot of clothes.
Hmm.
A lot of clothes. Then she ends up trying to sell them.
Mm.
Said, ah, no, yeah, and then we think is.
Mm.
I take care of my wife.
You take care
my
of
wife does not come from a rich family.
Mm-hmm.
No. Ambuya wangu is almost like a single mother as well.
Mm-hmm.
Ambuya wangu ni.
Yeah.
We are in Ambuya wangu, we are top shatter like this.
Yeah.
To eat a madine big taste, so to get a pass number, I'm going to tango taro. One of your moms, if I'm not going to marriage, got tenge se chakat. To tango to tenge, sir.
Right.
Kuto tango to the. People see me driving a lot of different cars and think some of them are mine. No. Ambe yangu kwa lato ndi bato ti shamba bali na damu taka nuko eka the fast taka moto eka daiso taka moto eka yamuni yano kubadha na wakashika ni moto yao
exactly
yeah the family is not even rich my wife's family is not rich my wife's family is yes in Zimbabwe same as me our families are literally the same literally the same
yeah.
They grew up with a single mother. They were taking care of my wife and my son. But two. So long, I don't see a panza. To Vamba Diaz or Dezo.
Nice.
Yeah. It's not a family rich.
So when you call yourself a millionaire, are we talking about USD, Irans, or Zimbabwe?
I never called myself a millionaire. It's people that decided to do that. And I embraced it. Ha ha! Yeah. Million! Ha ha! I will embrace that shit, bro.
Yeah.
I will like that, and I will say yes, it's me. Kapi na mbazun ka spend like $200 kadi na kwano for the yeah. Chaka yu pa chaka yu. Yes, dini.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kawana ka merka unga digi digi kaku tengira ka iPhone 15 kangu nim ka zwangu. Tiso awo to pila unga moti kedu tuenda pa den pedu to garam den midu Holland budembain.
Right.
The only place that I go out is Zimbabwe.
Mm-hmm.
I go out a lot here.
Right.
A lot here.
Mm-hmm.
I will go to these places. I've a lot of friends. Mm-hmm. I've developed friends. My friends, Angu, Nana, Rimon,
exactly.
Once is South African in now, boys, Dango,
yeah,
Musanitsekan, Skype at the entire motor, tender, and they say, Nemonaki on a life. And it's my friends, Angu,
yeah.
And I don't go out when I'm in South Africa, I stay home. Me and my wife, we have decided to make that home a palace.
Okay.
You saw my office.
Yeah.
I built that office into my house. It's in my house. Right now, I have bought a very huge monitor like this.
Yeah.
So that I've created a safe haven for me that I don't have to go out there and try to waste the little that me and my wife mm-hmm. have.
Oh, yeah.
The little that we make,
mm-hmm.
then I waste it out there.
So unotichi kune wapana vechidiki, I mean gringo, you know, wanata ma fake life on social media, even not wapana vechidiki, wamua wombecha ujama dara edu, I don't know, on social media, living fake life, you know, and wachizo influence wakuna wapana vechidiki, so kutindo life, ilu, in truth, wapana vechidiki wakuta succumb to pressure, you know, and if, because of this fake life, inige jitikopa social media, what do you have to say?
You see, that's what I was trying to tell you.
Mm-hmm. But chukuzo wana zaka, what type of social media these days?
Unaona uzinetika Ollah.
Mm-hmm.
Unaona dzungu kanditi.
Mm-hmm.
Dzungu urinenge AIDS. Dzungu parinoya pauri. Auzuzive.
Uh-huh.
Ndo maura anda AIDS. Ende dzungu haridi kumanje kuudzwa kunza imbaba. Mune dzungu imimi. Inenge AIDS. Hapana muna ndida kunza nayo.
Okay.
Ende kutuzive kuti unaro dzungu. Zvinotodawo mumwe wano ya kuti baba. Mune dzungu imi ndozo leta edzi edzi unenge unayo ndiwe muridzwayo ndiwe ukaibata iri muropa mako but kuti uzozikanwa zvinoda dokotera chiremba auye pauri kuti aiye waka chitanga ikunwa maperezi anditi ndozo noita dzungu izvi nda iwe muridzi unaro iwewe ndozo vanoita pano pamari wese hapana anoda kunza hana wevese anoda kunzi vanayo
nayo
nevasina vanoda kunzova nayo. Wanzwisisa ndozo akangoda kuita dzungu izvozvo zvonda vamwe vacho kutudebude kuti uchichana ngoro mukoma I think munoita zvinhu zvenyu nekakokurumidza munofanira kuita lola
kuti
kuti muti une dzungu zvo yatohondo makutorwa
yeah
wanzwisisa
yes
izvandikukudza izvi ndakatozvinzwa zvichiparidzwa nemutungamiri anondiparidzira kuti chikwera
right
kuti parinenge rave papa rasvika apa apana nda kunzanaro ritori mauri iwewe zvinokuti tichauya tichikuudzai kuti comrade I think muri kuita zvinhu zvenyu nechi nekakurumbidza itapotai muchisa ma break mbichana urikunzwa
yeah
inini Holland ndi kunyembera pressure inotosvikaone kwatiri ndinotombokanzwa so kamuka ka pressure to post something imbo post kana inonomira paduze nemotokari upost
yeah
even moto yacho sidi yakwe ngunomira papo uposte ka pressure kana kwatiri
right
we are growing up we are growing up
yeah very true
it's something that we have to grow out of. I would understand when we were 23, 24, 25
yeah,
maybe
yeah.
I would understand I understand people young people doing that. Is the time you have to do it. Embrace it whilst you are young. Do it. When people are trying to say, do it whilst you are young. But when you are growing up, understand pressure. Develop a skill.
Yeah.
In the Bible, it says, when you have a skill, you serve in front of kings. Whilst you have a skill.
Yeah.
I can decide right now to call certain people, big people, to call them. Hello, how far? Big people. Because of a skill that I have developed.
Yeah.
I don't need to fake it because I have a skill. The moment you develop a skill, like I said, this is coming from the Bible. Whosoever will have a skill shall save in front of kings. Who are kings now? The presidents, the what. Because you have developed a skill. You understand?
Yeah.
That's why I tell young people, develop a skill. You don't need to fake the life. You work so much harder on your skill.
Yeah.
So that you make so much money on your skill before you have done anything else.
Yeah.
Anything else. Stay at that stupid little job where you are getting, I was getting 2,500. Ola, let me tell you something. One day, ndiaburuka training in, like I told you, 2 kilometers, varamba yatanga kunaya. Urikunzwa? Varamba yatanga kunaya, ndine laptop yekubasa, ndakamhanya kunosvika muoffice. I was getting, ndaipinda muoffice inini, na 7, 8, basa richitanga na 9:30 baba. Vese zvichitanga kupinda varungu, ndakagara ndirimo. Ndainaiwa inini ndopinda mutule unoziva chihita cheche.
Exactly.
Ndoomesa hembe pachihita cheche ndovhu cheche. Ndoomesa varungu vaizosara kupinda muofisi ndakaoma ndakati gwa. Vasingazive nhamo dzese dzandapindana nadzo kuti ubati treni yeye inonetsa unoita ikubatirira ukadaiso.
Eish.
Uri kunzwa?
Yeah.
Inini Ona. Namo dzese dzodzo for only for me to get us to develop a skill. Varumbangwa ripa vaindi dzidzisa ola.
Ndizvinzwa.
Kuti ndiziwe siku writing a database, become a database administrator. I knew about that day. This one even give out for free. I was getting paid for it. 2,500 was nothing.
How do you tell that you know social media life is not real? You know, try to battle work one right now.
You don't have to be told that. Nothing there is real.
Mm-hmm.
There is a few people that are real there. Very few people that are real there.
Yeah.
Follow the pastors, the prophets, and what.
Mm-hmm.
Most of them are not even real there. Kari poke ka pastor ka mke kanunzi kana sine minenge ya general keka kanunzi ani chiwenga ka pastor ka zinga utoro he ma virgin he what kutsaga relevance kwikwi kuda kuti wanya anyanyanya anyanyunyararisa kuchecha kuna vana vasikuona YouTube yake kunyanyunyararisa kwikwi auno to oh my god I need these people and then you start faking it Salvation chaya haichadzidziswa paipai. Pa kutanga kutaura izvozi, ma virgin akazoti. Iwe. Mari yakakosha iyi ngaitsvagwe, babongo. Sa fake poto nyabero dzanzi ichichi. Enda mubhaibheri unotarisa peka zhinji kato pese pakataura mwari. Taitaura nani? Varombwa iva reference kuti Mazoshika mutau mono utzao varombo. Azudzwe murombo kaizvo.
Vai reference.
Vai reference kwa varombo kazhinji kacho mubhaibheri.
Okay.
Yeah.
But izvi zvese izvi zvazvikuri zvekune mari mari.
Yeah. Iwe, I'll tell you this. Do you know that Mwari akazviratidza? Jesu akazviratidza kuna Nebuchadnezzar, who was not even a Christian or a Jew or what he was Gentiles. Ndizo vangasika namati.
Yeah.
He saw Jesus Christ in Old Testament. He's the only person who saw Jesus Christ in Old Testament. Akataura kuti munhu andaona mwanenge mwana waMwari panga kanda vanhu mugomba baba. What was happening? This is a guy who does not Mwari akazviratidza kumunhu akazoti idzi dzine bags. Ndikadziratidza kune idzi dzikataura zvishuwa kuti kuchauya mwana waMwari vanhu vanoteerera
dzine mari
kuzi dzine relevance dzine influence dzine mari dzikamira pamberi pevanhu dzikataura kuti ndati ndaona mwana waMwari mugomba people started anticipating writing books they write those scriptures saying mwana waMwari ari kuuya this is in Old Testament this is happening in Old Testament when nobody knew about Jesus Christ And Jesus is showing himself to that man.
Yeah.
Who was not even anything close.
Yeah. So saying you are a millionaire, a gringo. Ne age your late 20s.
Yeah. I'm late 20s.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How were you able to make your first million?
I'll tell you this one. This one now is a teaching as well because it's how and where you spend your time. Sometime in South Africa, I continued going to church. There's UFIC in South Africa. I continued going to church. One day, in Midrand there, at Midrand Conference Center, a guy came to me at church. And he said, dude, I know you're a software guy. I was not even that big of a software guy. This is 2015. 2016. This guy is, I was an intern. This guy is telling me, sure, to dog there are software. I got die. Unosama Zuanita and a triple AMI.
Exactly.
My pyramid scheme.
Yeah.
So can Shamat, the software that dog gets like a nice work at nice. When I get a triple AM, dog gets all red work at
night.
And I said, I can do it. I was an intern. I did not even know how to do it. I went home.
But you had confidence.
I had confidence. I told that guy, my guy, let's have a meeting. To Rova Chinich. I went home. I knew a friend of mine. I got a pa chi kupa chimba chimba complex yo. Chanda nda kugara oso. Ne gara mu nana muva kuti ndikwase kuronga. Ndana kugara mune imwe yanga yagandwa ne curtain zo. Mu ama apartment anga kugandwa ne curtain ari ku Kempton Park. Munonzi muna Long Street ati. Yeah. Ndikomanda igare mu. Saka blaz pana plaza garo imwe apartment anga pazasa sai anga ari software engineer manje irova manje.
Okay.
Pana enda kwari ngati chama. Pane mfizi kuchesh kwedu. Andi udza dira katakatakata. Pati vana vata anubadraji. 5,000 kawa gazi rachina. Ini neoteta mara. Ndudu otingo TV jama. Sikana blaze apo. Ndudu otingo TV blaze no badro reenda.
Exactly.
Saka ngati so. Sikana mfizi bo ngati chilo vichinichi. Ndudu vandaenda vana sanga nwa nwa iwa. Vata gazi rachini cheche. Vana yon vatu badra mari yedu. Kasi batura 6,000.
Wow.
Rands.
Mm-hmm.
Ndini ndo tambila 2.5 ga.
Mm-hmm.
Nda piwa 6,000. Vanda share nimefe suangu 3,000. Vanda mayan vanda tingira ka TV kanku. Because it was not mari yangu ya ndae mireka ili pira kumwenzi. And it.
Mm-hmm.
When we made that system, those people told us, no, guys, you don't have to go. You do not make the system for us. System you don't operate way. So mimi chi launcha itaku launcha chinchinta kuchi market and vama kita chinchao pacha launch kwa Ollah. Ndopiga na babu wangu arpachuru kudai. Ngozo.
Mhm.
Mwaro anosio. We made 1 million in 5 days.
5 days,
1 million rand.
Wow.
I swear to God like this.
That's big.
We were just deciding kuti uda 40,000. To punch up system.
Mm-hmm.
Bam. These are pyramid schemes. Yeah. They were so high at that time.
Mm-hmm.
We made our system. It ran for a month.
Mm-hmm.
We were making money. We would decide, you want 5,000 over Pajam system. Probably all two pins on the phone. Shout out 5,000. And I want to start a system. They can talk to me like this. That's when I created my first account.
Okay.
I sent some Kuru account named Kuru back in 2016. Kuru, I said,
yeah. Yeah.
I sent some Kuru back in 2016. Novandava Mukuru Nganuvra account young in NetBank. Yeah. And then I received so much money that NetBank called me.
Kuti, where are you getting this money from?
Let's see your contract. Let's start again. To know on a contract. We had to write to explain how I got that money.
Wow.
And I bought my first car, 115,000 rands, a Kia Rio, a blue one.
Yo.
When you are posting this episode, I'll give you the videos. Mm-hmm. You put them, you can put the picture
there. Exactly, yeah.
I have the picture of my first car. My mother was even shocked. Everyone was shocked. I resigned where I was working. I said, nah.
I'm good now.
I'm okay now. Yeah.
Yeah, that's big.
After so, that, 2016, by around the end of the beginning of 2016, around the end of 2016, you know, a BMW 335i, I think it's F, what is it? I forgot what F is it. I bought that car, me.
Wow.
Yeah, I bought that car back in 2016.
So pyramid schemes, these are like money making schemes, but they're not straight.
Yeah, they're not straight. People actually make money, but people lose also money. Something you get in, you get out. Yeah.
We just get in and get out.
Yeah.
So how so who is losing when you are winning?
No. Remember when it starts, it's a pyramid. You need to understand. It's starting here and then it goes like this. So people who starting big,
they will benefit.
Getting money. Getting money. Because I joined a lot of pyramid scheme myself.
Yeah.
But I was quick. Put money. We can't lie to you, Gaguti.
So like,
you know, it's probably the same. I didn't know how it worked, that one. But it's literally the same. But our, the ones that we did back in the day were very easy. It's just a list. Let me explain how we did. We just created a system. System shows up a list. Ollah, 10,000. which means Ollah ruda 10,000.
Exactly.
Gringo vauya. Hai, ndoronzi Ollah ndaona uri pa list. Nda buka mari yako ndovoenda pana Ollah pepe vo click over to pay.
Mhm.
Ollah.
Ollah gets 10,000.
Ollah over to 10,000.
Right?
But inini in 24 hours ndakona 20.
How?
Right. I go back on the list now.
Mhm.
Gringo 20,000 mm-hmm. after 24 hours.
Right.
Ska 10,000 yango ya grower another 10 after 24 hours. Ska ndakubuda pa list pepe ndako ndakudoshi 20. Then another Ollah is going to come. Abdoshi ubati ai Gringo. Ndaona uda ndakubhuka mari yako pa list. Da ba. Vapatira 20. Sichidaro, sichidaro.
Okay.
Sichidaro, sichidaro.
But you gotta be clever. If you're not clever, you lose a lot of money.
Exactly.
You lose a lot of money.
But this is back in the day.
Uh-huh.
We did that. I managed to start paying my certifications. I tango improve my skill.
Mm.
Went on Udemy. I paid a year subscription.
Wow.
I started studying on Udemy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And as a certified cybersecurity analyst.
No, I'm not certified in cybersecurity. Mm-hmm. It's something that I taught myself.
Oh, you taught
I did not certify.
Okay.
I tried to do CCNAs and all of that.
Yes,
I didn't have time. I was now making money, prof.
But tell us, you know, how do accounts, you know, get hacked? Tell us about that. I hear
really,
a lot of people complaining about
it. Accounts don't really get hacked.
Mm-hmm.
But they are phishing links. You can receive a phishing link. A phishing link is a link that you receive in your email, and then that link looks like it's link that comes from Instagram, mm-hmm. from Facebook. You click on that link, says, no, reset your password. The moment you put your old password there, it says put your old password and put
exactly.
a new one.
Mm-hmm.
The moment you put your old password, you cannot in any link you're going to log into your Instagram. Mm-hmm. Of all, you can log into my Instagram. Do you want to change to me, right? Yeah. Da. You should go download it.
Yeah, and
in that one,
access
your password, your Wi-Fi.
Okay.
Doctor log in, doctor log out. Simple as that. That's a phishing link.
Mm.
Then there are brute forces that we use for emails. You want to brute force into some email?
Mm-hmm.
The brute forces. Yeah, yeah.
How do you do that? How do you?
It's, the brute force is just it creates a whole lot of leaks and then keeps on trying to get on. Then there's a lot of passwords that keeps trying and all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a lot of work. It's not it's not so easy. Mm. All of these young people that keep on saying, I do it. Ah, it's a lie, man.
It's
a lie. Some of them, but now there are now things where people have access to report you to Facebook.
Okay.
Yes, I can report your account to Facebook. Can report it until it gets banned forever, permanently.
Wow.
Yes.
You the hacker.
Yeah.
Okay.
There are algorithms that you can use to report an account consistently. Mm-hmm. Report it a million times.
Mm-hmm.
Facebook, this account is suspicious.
Yeah.
Buy a vital for revenue.
So you saw it in a previous interview that you did. You know, you said Passion Java bought 2 million followers in Pakistan.
Yes, it's true.
So when you were going to see it, tell me about that.
You said you were going to nonsense, man.
Those are not
real people, man. It's true.
So I are you saying that
it's not bad.
Based on the names like Pyongyang?
We know the accounts are not real. We know. Let me tell you something. They are, do you know they are called, what are they called? Farms, what farms that are in China there?
Mm-hmm.
That could actually give you
followers
and views.
Mm.
But my life, Jeff.
Okay.
My farms, I'm forgetting the right phrase that they use.
Mm-hmm.
There are farms there in China that there will be phones all over here.
Yeah.
They just go. Click, 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 follow.
Yeah.
Artists use those ones.
Okay.
Not artists only here in Africa. In America,
they use those
ones. Yeah, it's just that people here don't know.
Mm-hmm.
It's not bad. You can go and buy your followers so that you can attract more followers.
Mm.
Real ones. It's not,
okay.
It's not something bad.
It's
you
good.
Can go, you can, it's good. You want to monetize yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Don't ever listen to people telling you, I don't know, hey, he's buying followers, hey, he's fake. No.
Yeah.
You need those things.
Mm-hmm.
And a little Wayne did those things and made a lot of money.
They bought followers.
They bought views from those farms.
Yeah. But in terms of monetization, then how are you going to get money when, let's say...
The real ones are going to come.
Okay.
Seeing your numbers.
Mm-hmm.
The real ones are going to come.
Mm.
And then you will make your money.
Yeah.
You will monetize it. Mm-hmm. It's not something bad that people... I portray it like it's something bad. Be real, man.
Chet.
Be real. Don't lie to people that you don't want it. Mm. If you have an access to buy followers, you also want to buy it. You looking at me, you want to buy followers. Right now, I know you want. You just don't know where to buy them.
So, but do you have anything against Passion Java?
No.
What's your relationship like with Java?
I can text him. He can answer my text. Mm-hmm. He can text me.
Are you friends?
No.
You just have that.
Yeah, we know each other.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we are not friends. Certain things that he does it to the extremes.
Like what?
Nah, he does it to the extremes. I don't like that nonsense. No, no, zvinoita kamashoko. Mashoko anenge bepa. Katola bepa kuti bvara 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 bvara. Kari kanda uko. Nengo taura zvinhu zvakawandisa. Zvakawandisa, zvakawandisa.
Mhm.
Saka kukanzi chi recall everything that you have said. Mepo ikauya kati bvara mapepa aya.
Mhm.
You now don't know everything that you have said.
Mhm.
The reason why I saved my life is because I called to them.
Mm-hmm.
1 hour I was talking.
Mm-hmm.
What exactly did I say? So I know when somebody wants to fight me, mm-hmm. I know how to defend myself.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
I know what I've said.
Yeah.
Do you know some of my life, I script them.
Okay.
Yes, I script them.
Mm-hmm.
I look at my laptop. People don't see my laptop mm-hmm. because it's in front of me.
Yeah.
But when I'm talking to people, I go, I look at the facts. I'm reading facts.
Mm-hmm.
Reading facts. Oh, okay, I'm reading things.
Yeah,
I script my lives
mm-hmm.
so that I'm able to recall everything, every that little thing that I've said mm-hmm. to people,
mm-hmm.
so that I don't mess up relationships.
Yeah,
you understand.
So at one point, I remember there was a, you know, Magambeta Kanikaga, which put a hacker account on Java. You know,
he actually did.
Mm-hmm. What happened? I to fishing.
I don't know. I don't know. I was not paying attention. I was busy. I was working.
Mm-hmm.
So I saw my codes, someone is trying to, and it came a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So it was too much.
Mm-hmm.
And then I just switched off my phone
mm-hmm.
because I was busy. I was actually on Teams working.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it becomes hectic when exactly. we are going live with mm-hmm. with a project or something. So I just ignored it. He actually successfully did it. Then I just reported the account and the account got deleted because mm-hmm. I reported it. I just permanent banned my account.
Oh, yours? So
that, yeah, mm-hmm. a permanent ban. I banned it personally. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got help from one of my brothers. He's mm-hmm. a young friend of mine.
Mm-hmm.
And then he just permanent banned the account.
Mm-hmm.
Then after that, then I went, bought another account,
mm-hmm.
which had a little bit of followers.
Yeah.
Then I became back.
Mm.
Yeah, but him, because of, he wanted to be, he has this childish behavior that he does. And then he actually successfully did it.
Mm.
Yeah.
So did you then reach out to Kwaru, Jako, Mkoma Alpha?
No, he hasn't come longer.
Mm-hmm.
So why would I say Mkoma Alpha? Just ignored. They called me on a video call with Partisan and what. Yeah, mm-hmm. talking. I was like, nah, nonsense.
Mm.
But you see, I don't like to talk about these people. They get this relevance from my name. No, I'm too big. Yeah?
Mm.
I can't be talking about these people. Now they're going to feel like they're big.
Okay.
Yeah, I know.
And and Drono uchimu blaster a lot Java, and you saying he's not a prophet. I know chingito name kadzi mota zake zedzi and did zeku kasel kwatsano wake, you know, ana mari because he doesn't own any asset in his country. And
you know when you're married, you know when you're married and your wife has some things, they are also yours.
Yeah, I understand, but
so
is there any truth in these, you know, things you say, or it's just a way
even
of chasing clout?
Even if I said it, or if somebody said it,
mm.
it might be true. But even if it's true,
mm-hmm.
if I'm married and my wife buys a car,
mm-hmm.
it's our car, so it's not. There's nothing wrong there.
Okay, fine. But are you saying Java doesn't have money to buy those cars, or he doesn't afford?
I wouldn't know. He's in America. I've never been to America.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to go.
Okay.
I wouldn't know.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't know. You see, like I said, giving these people relevance does not teach young people.
Mm-hmm.
anything out there.
Yeah.
Talking about, hey, he made money, does not give. You know that boy was a Scripture Union leader in Segetu when I was there.
Mm.
Yes. Segetu High School.
Yeah.
He's made himself very good to go to America.
Yeah.
And become who he is now.
Mm-hmm.
We acknowledge that.
Yeah.
But let's leave God out of it, man.
Okay. So are you saying you can never talk ill of someone for clout? To seek relevance?
I can.
You can?
I can. If I want to trend, and I know that I want to trend right now, I can.
Mm-hmm.
I can use your name.
Have you done it before?
Yes. A lot.
To who?
To a lot of people. But it's just if I'm watching you about it, like, understand, I'm going to put it in home open.
Are you saying Stana is not successful?
No, it's not.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
But Stana is good. Stana is making it.
Oh.
So tell me more when you say he's...
No, he's not. He's not. He's just there. He's just okay. He's okay. It's not bad. But at 43, 44, I wouldn't be there.
Okay.
Nah, I mean...
So sometimes you make him trend.
Yes. I make him trend.
How?
I can use his name. He knows. I even told him sometime.
Mm-hmm.
That... Unoita ma mistakes aga wanted, at least to not pa content.
Mm-hmm.
Uga ngoita mistake, to shansa mistake yoyo.
Kutarani shayo.
To itawa la mistake yoyo, to igoko zera, pa, mistake yoyo, kushika nda trend. Ugumbo itile ma mistake.
So imwe ya waga mungu blasa na ya waga mungu nikinanya ndibi?
Ayo, no, tijua batira fana. Tijua batira, like, wanunga chubuda wa chitashe, chifana fana. No, manya, chitamba ndombolo, chitamba ndombolo, pambiri pe kamera, 8:45. What are you doing? You know, my 45 years.
He's just having fun, you know.
Unosan mai kichu mbana mokura mangani. Hasa ni 44, 45, 43. 40, maybe. I mean, you go very, very, very young. Same age. Stana.
Yeah? But they are living...
Gombo, my life's out.
But Stana is a celebrity.
So? Mike is celebrity. Mike Jimumbe is more of a celebrity than he than
okay. How do you deal with toxicity on social media?
I don't pay attention to rubbish. I don't pay attention. There are a lot of people who try to be relevant using my name, you know. Right now I saw somebody commented on some post, reminding a post in Bawa Gringo Atenga Doro my 4 AM.
Exactly.
Then I was reading the comments and I posted on English page on Zimlima also.
Mm-hmm.
So I was reading. And then I saw some idiots commenting, no, this boy is a fraudster. I realized myself that these are 39-year-olds talking about me.
Yeah.
And me and buying alcohol in a club.
Mm.
This is obsession, man.
Yeah.
These people are obsessed with me. I like it. Enjoy my life.
Yeah.
Yeah, my life, your TV. Jinimbi told us that.
Live TV.
Yeah, my life, your TV. Enjoy it.
Mm.
Yeah. You can be toxic as you want. I don't care.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can marry. What? There are people with money that are not happy as I am. They are not. They don't even have the clout that I have. Clout is good.
Right?
There is no bad publicity.
Mm-hmm.
My brother, they call you clout chaser. Chase it.
Chase the clout.
Clout is good. Right now, on this phone.
Mm-hmm.
If I bring out the phone numbers of people that I know, if I text, they answer right now.
Mm-hmm.
Big people.
Yeah.
Big people. Mm-hmm. I told you about the internet.
Yeah.
She's big. One of the biggest women, successful women here in Zimbabwe. Because mothers in nigga business. I'm going to call someone to connect with her. I'm going to tell her. I'm going to call her. Pah. I'm going to pay her number. I'm going to tell her. Why?
Let's talk about the boy child. You know, Kashinju, we talk of a girl child and third line, the boy child, your gringo. The boy child is going through the most these days. And because sometimes Shinga and all sorts. So as a man, what are some of the struggles you've gone through, you know, that you couldn't speak out?
It's a lot, man. You know, we have gone through the hardest times in life.
Mm-hmm.
We have lost people that we thought were going to give us life.
Mm-hmm.
And there are a lot of certain things. There are a lot of certain things that people say on social media, not knowing somebody's really going through it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I lost everything.
Mm.
Everything, everything. Before COVID, actually in COVID, couldn't even pay mortgage. Couldn't even pay nothing. And my car was about to be taken back by the bank. Nothing. I lost everything. But because I'm a man, I told myself, okay, it's fine. I'll find another place to go and look again. Sold everything that I was left with. Closed the house. Sold everything. Closed the house. Got into a plane. Went to Dubai.
Yeah.
Started looking for a job in Dubai.
Mm.
Things were bad.
In Dubai?
Yeah, in Dubai.
Mm.
People don't know. Things were bad. I'm now looking for a job. People started saying, Gringo, I was looking for a place in Dubai. It was a lie.
Mm.
I wasn't even getting out of the house in Dubai.
You were just in your house?
Yeah. But I got into the mosque there. To the extent that one day I slept outside.
Mm. Why?
Because I didn't have money to pay for the place to stay.
And where was your wife?
I was with her. Together,
We
slept outside.
Mm.
Do you know Dubai is hot?
Yeah, very, very hot. Yeah, I've been there.
Yes, we slept outside. To one of my friends said, no, my mate, come stay here. We stayed together. Then whilst I was there, then I got a connection that made me money. That's why when I came back, after everything that people had said, came back, saw me people driving a very big car.
Yeah.
And they were shocked. Like that.
How come?
This guy was struggling in Dubai.
Mm-hmm.
But because I'm a man, I had to try that. Try and fail.
Mm-hmm.
I did not lose anything because I didn't have anything.
Yeah.
But I tried.
Mm-hmm.
Soon as I got money, I quickly married my wife.
Mm-hmm.
That money that I got.
Yeah.
Because we were there sleeping outside together.
Together, yes. Yes.
I married her. Said, okay. Now I decide to grow up now.
Mm-hmm.
Since then, I've not lost anything.
Mm. How did you, I think you haven't told us how you made that money.
I will not tell anybody. I just got a very good connection. Life brought us that. People that we know. People that
out there.
Yes. But it's not something that everybody does. When people see somebody successful, don't ever think that it's always about chakamshonga and all that. Some people are just blessed. Let me tell you something. People don't know. I was told by Prophet Makandiwa, a long time ago in Hebron, he was doing some Thursday prayers. I said to myself, I'll go to these Thursday prayers. I have to go.
Yeah.
I went there. Then we were a few people, I think we were less than 15. If he sees this, he knows. I'm telling the truth. We were less than 15. Him and his wife. He came. Papa Serbe parking lot. And then he started. We started praying. Then he looked at me and said, let's pray. You people, you don't know where we are going. You don't know where you are going. Since that day, even in that neta sin is not gonna send. Shaka woma. I just remember that word. I don't know where I'm going. Where I'm going is bigger than where I was. Where I was yesterday is going to be bigger than where I'm going to be tomorrow. You understand?
Yes.
I don't need to go no changamshonga. The word that I was told back then by that man, I'm still living with it today, until today.
Yeah.
You can see me bow and go down, but you can say, no, put a momo, son, and the Ganango church, then you thought, couldn't wait and the Gambo Woods. The quantum queen, the quantum zero, quantum finals, it's successful.
Yes.
I just kept that word, and that's it.
Yeah, that's powerful. So as a society or as a nation, how best can we then change then that narrative, you know, you could see, of a boy, child, to also have a voice?
You see, men, we cry a lot and people don't know. You sit there, you have a wife, you have a family, and there's no money or rent. I was going to say, uchaita say. Believe in something.
Yeah. You said believe in something.
Yes. Can also have a church, can also have a mwari. Believe in something. You have faith.
Mm-hmm.
Believe in something, that something supernatural.
Satanism?
I don't care what it is. Would if you decide, if it works for you, amen. But usangu itachi enda na kuyenda, chizengirele, uchungu.
But would you join Satanism for you to make money?
No, never.
For the sake of money?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm born again. I'm a baptized Christian. I'm just not religious.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people don't understand when I say I'm not religious.
Mm.
I don't. And this is just one thing. Yes, it's true. You go Roma. So that's so. Yes, it's true. If I see, don't worry. Don't buy into anything. Just wira.
Church.
Angu. Kugalon church. Wira profit. Angu ni. Problem. I don't need to fight for that, man.
No need.
Why? He can fight for himself.
So tell me something, Gringo. You know, what business are you into? Since, I mean, you're an entrepreneur.
I'm in technology. Mm-hmm. We build systems.
Mm-hmm.
I build financial systems,
mm-hmm.
insurance systems.
Yeah.
That's what I do.
Mm-hmm.
I build a lot of wallets, money wallets, and what.
Mm-hmm.
I'm an engineer. I write Python. I write business intelligence reports and everything. Mm-hmm. That's what I do.
Okay.
And the business is, I try to do certain things. I'm working on farming now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And how much money are you making out of that?
In my business, which technology?
Mm-hmm.
I'm making a lot, man.
A lot of money?
Yes. We're making a lot. We're making enough for me.
So
to
as a youth leader, have you created employment, you know, for the youth since...
Not really. Not entirely. We have on certain projects.
Mm-hmm.
On certain projects. Yeah, we have.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we have.
So as we sum up, you know, El Gringo, we talked about Java. You also, this is Fali Pupa, which is you, Anna Marie, and even went on to say, Mwarara,
Fali is different. People don't have to take it serious because he's my friend.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Fali is my friend.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of people see things that I say and then they take it out of context.
Mm,
I don't know.
Yeah.
We create content for you. We are content creators. We have to create that.
So some
content.
Of the content is not even real.
Like I said,
mm-hmm.
99.9% of the things that you see on the internet is not real.
Mm.
But young people, they just need to be taught content creation is real. It's happening.
Happening, yeah.
Young people in America are making a lot of money with content creation.
Yeah.
Do it.
Wow.
Don't sit at home there. No one is coming to rescue you.
Yeah.
My brother, my sister. There is no politician that is going to come and give you money.
Mm-hmm.
Those people, they are also hungry. They were crying that they don't have money to go to the parliament. They have got billions. It was said, it was set up. Pono did a few $10.
Yeah.
Van tell that van amari kupa yende papa. As if I'm going to vote in my office. But now to change of, but not determine. Could I end no gare go computing in billion? But you tower out pay you head issues. Van were to expect to talk about that. They are not going to come and help you.
Powerful.
They are going to do whatever it costs. So that they please the president more. They want to please the president more than you. And yet you are the ones that put them in the office. I will say this without fear or anything.
Yeah.
It's important that the people that we have given our lives to, the people that determine the future of young people, go into these offices and know what they are there for. You failed. You failed to take care of your 6 people family.
Yeah.
And now you have been trusted with thousands of a constituency. It's now in your hands. And yet we have trusted you. We know that you failed your family. But we trusted you that you will do better with 1,000 people. We are stupid. We accept that. But to prove us wrong. Don't stand in front of people and cry. What were you thinking when you were putting your face on a poster? You thought that this position was going to give you money. No, you are a public servant. You are saving the people that have trusted you with that position.
That's very powerful. Coming from El Gringo, youth president, here on the Ola 7 podcast show. So, what is your net worth?
Let me tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lesson as well for the people that are out there.
Mm-hmm.
Go and learn public relations. Never answer questions like this one.
Mm-hmm.
Never. Go and learn how to deal with public. When somebody invites you to an interview and then he asks you a question like this, don't answer that question. Find a way to dodge it. Me, I'm dodging it right now.
Why? We want to know your network.
It's important. It's imperative for young mm-hmm. people to know that these are the questions that you're not supposed to answer.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Because it does not help anyone out there and it does not help you.
Mm-hmm.
It does not build an empire for you. Somebody hears that, Gringo is worth $100. Gringo is worth $2 million. Gringo is worth $5 million. Now they don't, it creates.
Or should we say maybe you are dodging the question or you're going to dodge the question simply because you don't have that money that matches, what people think or what people assume could you worth this much.
It's important to let people curious.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you something. Munu mutema chaka guna panyika panapa. Akatadza ku explain upenyu wako, akatadza ku explain the way you live, akatadza ku explain what you do. It leaves them curious enough to start building something for themselves. Ndachaka gone kwa nevanhu vatema kuda kudzidza upenyu hwavanhu kuti ari kumborana masei kwei vakatadza kuverenga kuti iwe nevanhu vandakarambana navo unoziva zvana heu komanda watoti ndaiwirira navo vanhu vaivai takarambana vakatadza kunzwisisa kuti kuaenda kuDubai how ari kumbozviita sei vakatanga ndobva vatenga kufambisa ari kusvika mapiletsi kuDubai ichi ndakazoenda kune mukase uchida unotenga imwe motikari vandasvika ikoko kuti akudzwa navanhu vanotengesa mukase wevongozi iwe kutakanzwa kuti iwe uri kuDubai uri kutambura ndikati ndingaonda
$500,000
That's it. That's how you must live your life. Don't explain your life to people. Let them be so curious that they don't know how you are living.
Are you into mining as well?
I'm not into mining.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even have any mine. Mm-hmm. I'm not even into mining. I don't even know how those things go around.
Okay.
I just know Scott.
Mm-hmm.
I can call Scott and ask for money
mm-hmm.
if I want to. I've never done it though. But okay. If I want to. So I'm not into mining.
Mm-hmm.
But let me tell you something. Do you know that a lot of people come and try to give you advice when you left Star FM?
Yeah.
What was the reason? Because they couldn't explain how is this guy living an employer trying to be an employer. Because you did not explain to anybody.
Exactly.
Leave people, live your life. Vanhu vatema vakatadza kuexplain upenyu hwako. Chavanongogona kuzotanga kuti haana mari, haana mari. Rimwe ndakazonzwa kuti hamufani vanenge vasangana sendi yekutenga bhodhoro re champagne yamuri kutaura. Murume mukuru akagara muimba $50 million. Anoda kutira kuexplaina bhodhoro $200 raposwa kuZimbabwe yari South Africa. Obsession iyoyo inoita kuti vatambure vatadze kunzwisisa kuti akumbozviita sei akumborarama sei vakatadza mukadzi wangu akarova madouble drone ma20 inches votaiwa mukadzi wacho saka ndiane mari izvozvo zvinoita kuti vatambure vatadze kunzwisisa kuti uri kuzvigona sei nakirwa neizvozvo embrace don't ever explain your life.
So profound.
Someone comes to you, unemari itandina. Akatizona unovati yes. Ukatizona unakana sendi kutenga hene soti yes. Vuma. Don't even ever give them the ability to explain your life, the options to be able to know everything about your
about
life.
Your life, yeah.
Never ever make your next move so public.
Mm-hmm.
Your next move must be very, very private so that you can embrace it when you arrive there.
Yeah.
You create your own future.
So you married recently. How is marriage treating you?
Nice. Look at me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm even fit. I'm living the best life. I married the best person.
Are you still in the honeymoon phase?
Yes. The honeymoon phase for me, it can go. We are going, we celebrated our 2-year anniversary recently.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Me and my wife.
Mm-hmm.
My wife is young. Me, I'm young. Damn, that thing is nice. Fuck, I'm enjoying, bruv.
I'm enjoying.
Oh, me.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Look at me. enjoyed that life, Baba. Just chickens is no scapa den and I got to be kill what you decide na Buddha and Tanga down. I'm enjoying that life. Never ever think of no. Go down the injury, I still. And I got no one's gonna go under.
Yeah.
I was a late bloomer. I think in any church, I was so late. I think maybe I don't even think I can reach 20 or 10.
How's it going?
I don't think so. Okay. I just don't go around.
Come a pick and drop.
Turn a story to tell.
My pick and drop.
Yes, here you
go. That is really cool.
Yes, here you go.
So, what is your message to all young couples out there?
Enjoy life. Don't expect too much from each other. It's marriage, it's about learning every day. It's a learning curve.
Yeah.
And women must understand men are stupid. The stupidest thing that has been created is men.
Mm-hmm.
And women must be very patient.
Mm.
Men also must be very patient with women.
Yeah.
There's no one who's perfect. Me and my wife, we've just decided, no, you know what? No, none of us is perfect.
Mm-hmm.
We fight. Me and my wife can fight and then we can go maximum 2 hours without talking to each other. But we need each other.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to lie to you.
Mm-hmm.
Church, my church,
mm-hmm.
where I go to,
yeah,
brought me to where I am.
Wow.
Everything that you see about me, everything, even this for this marriage to work.
Mm-hmm.
There's church. A man there in South Africa
who's
a brother to Prophet Makandio
mm-hmm.
who has always... on me like this.
Mm-hmm.
Spiritually and physically.
Mm-hmm.
I can play FIFA with that guy.
Yeah.
And you can... People don't even know.
Mm.
I can play FIFA with him. He used to come to my house when I was a bachelor. Every time he wants, he can come and teach me. Because I've decided that I have to have somebody that I look up to.
Yeah.
That he has made it.
Mm.
It's important, it's imperative for everybody, every young people. You have that person, you have a mentor, you have somebody that you look up to.
Very true.
That you can go to when you need something.
Yeah.
So I've tried by all means to make that man my look up to guy.
Mm,
say,
yeah.
Okay, no. When things are hard, he has to be there. He has to know the truth.
So now, before you go, El Gringo, your message to the boy child who is striving to make it, a better life out there, and also the young girl and youth at large.
To the young people who are women, boutique is not the only business that you can do. And is it? Can I waru omsana and it's wapi omara and it's watu ita marnechi ni papa and it's to marry toto chilekeza kuita every day. A skill. Staying at a job where you are getting the minimum.
But while it's just there, are you supporting or are you encouraging Kuruamsana?
No.
Okay.
I'm not encouraging anything.
Mm-hmm.
Don't try to act like it's not happening.
Mm-hmm.
It's happening. Mm-hmm. It's there. It's happening.
Yeah.
You sleep with a man, you get money. They are doing it, these young people.
Mm-hmm.
Let's not try to run away from it. Let's teach them that it's not right, but let's not run away that is they are doing it. You understand?
Yeah.
Even after you have done it, grow out of it. Grow out of it. Pray to God. Get forgiveness. Build a skill. After that, build a skill that will solve a problem somewhere. A boutique is not the only... People are not walking around naked anymore. That is not the only business that you can do. Think of something.
Drop a new idea here. What else can they do?
There's a lot that you can do. There's a lack of technology. Women in technology. Do you know that you can learn everything on the internet right now? There's lack of women in technology at the moment.
Right.
In mining, there's lack of women in mining.
Mm-hmm.
In farming, there's lack of women in farming. And get this one. This is very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
Things, if you have tried and they are not working in Zimbabwe, don't get scared to leave.
Mm-hmm.
Ola.
Right.
Musafuri levana kuti eh garachete munyika ndai he nyika yedu what azvisi kuita zvaramba buda enda ukawana mukana teresa kana wawana mukana sambofa kafurirwa hey avari nogeza chembera kuti asevera kuti ase they are earning 4,000-3,000 pounds and they are living a better life. Don't die before your time because you want to stay in Zimbabwe.
But it's causing now, if all of them, you know, wakabuda out of the country, it's now causing brain drain in Zimbabwe.
Yes, it's important.
To cause brain drain?
Yes.
Why?
Listen to me. There is a minister of finance, I don't know what's his name, who has asked the question recently. And he said, Mara esiku wanika kunyika saka takuda kuitora muno. Kuda kutora muno munani mune munasiri kuenda kubasa. Which means vakatono itsvaka kunze. Ivo vakano itsvaka kunze iwe ndiwo usoda kuenda kunoitsvaka kunze. Iwe ndiwo manje usoda kuenda. Ivo vakatoenda kunoitsvaka kunze. How many times have you heard that vaenda kunotsvaka ma relationship ku Europe. Vaenda kunotsvaka ma relationship kwakati. They are going there to look for relationships and yet you are being told don't go there and look for relationships. How does that even work?
But we also need our skilled workers here in Zimbabwe.
We need skilled workers. That's why we improve. We tell the people that are in the diaspora, us, me, if I am to get a position in Zimbabwe right now to come back, I'm coming back.
Yeah.
I'm registering a company. I've registered the 3 companies already in Zimbabwe.
Right.
I'm bringing that skill that I've learned in South Africa back home.
Right.
It is important.
Mm-hmm.
It is very, very important.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something, an example. Tito Vara, Tagari Zakapan. Was in Switzerland for the longest time. Have you ever heard that guy before? Before he was put as finance something, no? Something. Have you ever heard about him before? Where was he? In Switzerland. Working in some biggest bank there. What was he doing there? Building a skill. Even my brother can say, I want you to come to Zimbabwe. They are going to take those people there, out there, bringing them here. They're not going to take you because you have no experience. Go and build experience out there. They will call you when their jobs are back here.
Okay.
Mutuli Ncube was nothing. People, nobody knew about him. He came from Switzerland, started staying in Mikus. The government started paying for his flights, going back to go see his family back in Switzerland. President said, no, this guy is very much experienced. Let's take him. He has worked in European banks for the longest time. He knows about money. And he has a doctorate, whatever he has, that he has acquired from those countries back out there. Why did they take him? Why did they take him? Ufunga jamu nama professor. Vangana kudzidzisa use it up. Vanena ne buti akakwasharira kudai so professor. Professor ari kuyazo kudzidzisa iwo kuti ugute degree iwo. Ane buti akadai so. Ari kuyakadikitira ane underwear yakatsemuka pakati apa. Professor. Ane PhD.
Okay.
It's real. You people don't want to tell these young people reality. You focus on alpha, so next day you penga zvinonga chita pa social media. We, me, you mean one ari gano kudza ichokwati ich. Ich chochi ich. Pana ndiri one. Chete, hakuna mumwe.
Hadza hakuna mumwe.
Hakuna.
That's El Gringo of the Ollah 7 podcast show. And my brother, your parting remarks.
Thank you. I like this one. I like this set. Thank you. I like the setup here. They are very, very much expensive cameras in here. Blackmagic is tough for here. And thank you so much for inviting me here. And thank you guys that they are at the background, the engineers and stuff. See, it was Farage. Young people, I don't want to tell you a lot of things, but find these Ollah people, find them, find the way you can collaborate and create content and start to try to make money. People are making money from YouTube. Do it. Try it. If it fails, it fails. Mm-hmm. You have nothing to lose. Wagara una kana send. Saka kuzama akuna basa.
Akuna kuipa.
Akuna kuipa. Mm-hmm. Akuna kuipa. Ma imashokojeta nungova bamrom pako. Mm-hmm. Osbatsira. Musaite pride. Mm-hmm. Even kana usina vumauta una ubatsirika. Mm-hmm. Andidika.
Very true.
Exactly.
Mashoko mambaruta baba. I'm sure people are learning, and also I'm convinced that a lot of people out there have been inspired by this, you know, session.
They have to be inspired. You will change what of Wunduka, so don't put a podcast. And to go and see some big names. Can all these are big names? I can't say Sana Gringo. No, Fana Gupunduka, so good. Yeah, my power, my big names up.
Right?
Hey, I've created this name. Uh-huh. This name is now a brand.
Uh-huh.
And Dinaja Emba and Tangi and Kuprinda Emba and Sodaro. And my man,
El Gringo, El Gringo, Papa, Gringo, Chi.
I don't want to do a gringo, so I'll go primary. I don't know if I'm
going to gringo. Yeah, but I'm not my resemblance.
Exactly. And then the Vandazo Tasso Kura man, Vandas Tango and a Pablo, Nicholas Mashasha. But as I realized, oh no, man. I can make this thing work.
Exactly.
And then I created something unique. And then I was looking for something that is not there.
Then he said L Gringo.
Yeah.
L for Elvis.
EL.
E-L.
E-L, yeah. It means a lot in Mexico there. Master, Mambo, El Pablo, El Chapo.
Okay. Exactly. El Gringo.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, my biggest names.
El Chapo. Oh, yeah. I see. Yeah. Makes sense.
But in my name is Alois Tatenda Muzea. That is my real name.
All right. Yeah. Alois Tatenda Muzea.
Yes.
It's been a pleasure, my brother.
Thank you, my
Thank you so much for coming.
Jay, thank you so much.
That's El Gringo on the Ollah 7, a podcast show. And we promise to give you more and more interviews on this platform. You know, and, you know, I think I've learned a lot from this guy. This podcast show is there for you guys, and also to change the narrative. Also, sometimes the way we perceive these people out there, one of the no, guys, so the reality, not what you see on social media, but the reality. You get to know everything on this platform. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for supporting us, our viewers, our sponsors. Oh, guys, thank you so much. No good tender, Guru, and a kiss on electronics. Thank you so much, guys. Bachelor's Republic, thank you. I want to say thank you to my behind the scenes team. We've got Mike Loud 5 Mushungi, the guy behind the cameras, you know, and also sound. And big shout out to Pat Son as well. And Nyengetelai Dingana, our madam producer, the Dimple Lady. Nyenge the Dimple Lady, she's our producer. Thank you so much, guys. We are a team, you know, here at the Ollah 7 podcast show. And my sponsors and also will list I miss and gago and gazo who paid zai. But another baker's in, I'm sure my advice Murungwa ona to no good 10 days, guru guys. Thank you so much. Kwanas, bye bye.
You haven't tasted rice until you taste Auntie Flo's Quilombero rice. It brings out the flavor and taste in every meal. It's priced right as well. $4 for 2 kgs, $10 for 5 kgs, and $100 for 50 kgs. Available at Eastgate Market Shopping Center in Harare and Fidelity Life Center in Bulawayo. Or simply WhatsApp us on the numbers on screen now. Auntie Flo's Quilombero rice. Delicious. Tasty, mouth-watering. From as little as $20, your Christmas and New Year's could be filled with entertainment. We provide free-to-air decoders, smart TVs with built-in satellite receivers, tech support for all our products second to none. Find us in Harare, Mutare, and Mashingo. For more information, WhatsApp us on the numbers appearing on screen now. Kesson Electronics. Grab yours today.